Hi, everybody. In this presentation, we will show you the basics of the SENA 50C. If you skip the camera information, this presentation also applies to the 50S and the 50R. This communications and camera combo does so much, this could be a 2-hour video. So I will only go over the basic functions to get you up and running, like phone calls, communications, music functions, and doing videos and the software to use to edit that video. When the presentation is finished, it will just wet your whistle to dig deeper into the 50C manual and the video and movie editing software manual I recommend from MOV AVI. You will need to download the SENA motorcycle app to your phone, the SENA camera app to your phone, and the device manager to your computer. Let's go over the unit itself and locate all the dials and buttons. We'll just follow the illustration on the screen from top to bottom. On the front face, there's the mesh antenna, the mesh intercom button, status LED, jog dial. On the front, lens, and the field of view is 120 degrees and the aperture is f/2.4. On the bottom, camera button, micro SD card slot, DC power charging and firmware update port. On the back end, speaker and microphone port, phone button. Phone button is just a name, keep that in mind. In order to turn the unit on and off, you need to understand what a tap and a hold is. They are just that. A tap is a tap, and a hold is a hold. Tap, release. Hold down for designated time, release. To turn the unit on and off, press and release the phone button and the jog dial at the same time as described in the illustration. When you turn the unit on, you will hear.
Hello.
When you turn the unit off, you will hear.
Goodbye.
Now, turning the main unit on and off is one of the few things you cannot do with voice commands. By the way, what is the difference between a voice command and a voice prompt? A voice command is something you say to the unit, "Hey, SENA, check battery." A voice prompt is something the unit says to you, "Battery level is high." First of all, insert a micro SD card into the card slot to use the camera. Tap the camera button, camera on. When the unit is on, hold the camera button for 1 second, release, recording. When recording is on, hold the camera button for 1 second, release, stop recording. Tap the phone and camera button, camera off. Or you could use the voice commands. Hey, SENA, camera on. Wait for double beep. Hey, SENA, recording. Hey, SENA, stop recording. Hey, SENA, camera off. Tap, press, and release the camera button to take a photo. You will hear a shutter sound. Click, click. There is no voice command for taking still images. Important note. In standby mode, the camera will turn off in 5 minutes to conserve the battery. Important note, if you are recording in 2160p, 30 frames per second of video resolution, you cannot take a photo. In the camera app, you can set up many parameters like resolution, photo modes, time lapse, mic gain, date captions, speaker sound recordings. Here are a few of the camera app pages and images for you. The camera can use up to a 128 gigabyte card. For more information, read the manual for all of the setting modes. So take a listen and a look here. headset pairing for the first time or in the following situation, a factory reset or delete all pairings.
Hello. Phone pairing. Your headset is paired.
If you already started the unit and none of the above applies, and the unit is in standby mode, blue LED slowly blinking, press and hold the phone button until you hear phone pairing. Have your phone in find devices. Hello, beep beep, phone connected.
Phone pairing. Your headset is paired.
Or you can just say, hey SENA, phone pairing. Hey, SENA, phone pairing.
Phone pairing. Your headset is paired.
So now we'll show you how to get to the configuration menu and move around in it. There are a number of connections and features you can access, but from here you need to read the manual.
Phone connected. Group intercom. Intercom pairing. Configuration menu. Delete all pairings. Remote control pairing. Universal intercom pairing. Exit. Delete all pairings. Exit. Exit.
So mesh intercom. What is mesh intercom? It is a dynamic communication system created by SENA that provides instant and effortless bike-to-bike communication without a pre-grouping process. Mesh intercom allows riders to connect and communicate with nearby users without the need to pair each headset together. The working distance between the 50C and mesh intercom can be up to 2 kilometers, 1.2 miles. In open terrain. In open terrain, the mesh can be extended up to 8 kilometers, 5 miles between a minimum of 6 users within the same channel on open mesh or the same private group in group mesh. 6 users can talk at the same time and enjoy the optimal quality of their conversation. Press mesh button and you go into mesh. Press the mesh button to turn off open mesh. Here is the coolest feature you may not know about, bridging your Bluetooth friends into your mesh conversation. Let's ride with Joe Mesh and Sam Bluetooth. Bill and Betty arrive and they cannot talk to Bill and Sam without stopping and setting it up. Well, that doesn't even matter now because Terry and Tom of Bill's group and Dean and Dave of Sam's group arrive. They have already been connected to their friends, Bill and Sam, via Bluetooth. So Bill's group of 4 can talk to each other. Sam's group of 4 can talk to each other, but they cannot talk to the other group. Joe and Bill change to mesh, and now all of their friends get bridged into the conversation using mesh. But wait, there's more. As planned, the 5 buddies arrive, all with mesh, as they can ride into range. All 13 riders can talk to each other 6 at a time. Like I mentioned in my last video, this Bluetooth bridge thing is a convenient thing until the procrastinators wise up and get newer mesh units. Also, you are only as strong as the weakest link, so eliminate the weak links. These weak links mess up the following function big time. The working distance between each 50C and mesh intercom can be up to 2 kilometers, 1.2 miles, in open terrain. And in open terrain, The mesh can be extended to 8 kilometers, 5 miles, between a minimum of 6 users, within the same channel on open mesh, or the same private group in group mesh. 6 users can talk at the same time and enjoy the optimal quality for their conversation. Lastly, all this excitement of writing together and conversations going on between all these writers is being recorded into your 50C. The last segment was fantastic, right? Well, things can go terribly wrong if you do not follow protocol. Bluetooth gets mixed up with mesh in incorrect connections, and you have what is called a closed loop. Let me read this notice to you that is in your manual. Remember, you can pause this video and study this diagram if you like. The audio quality will be reduced if a 50C connects to 2 or more Bluetooth intercom friends while in open mesh or group mesh when using mesh intercom. If a closed loop is created as shown below, each user will experience severe noise issues. SENA recommends that a closed loop not be created. Secondly, if Bluetooth intercom is accidentally turned on during mesh intercom, communication between 50C helmets is shown below. You will hear a voice prompt, mesh intercom disabled, Bluetooth intercom connected, every 1 minute. If you turn off the Bluetooth intercom or turn off the mesh intercom, the voice prompt will no longer come out.
Mesh intercom disabled. Bluetooth intercom connected. Mesh intercom disabled. Bluetooth intercom connected. Mesh intercom disabled. Bluetooth intercom connected. Mesh intercom disabled. Bluetooth intercom connected.
Hey, SENA, check battery.
Check battery. Battery level is high.
Hey, SENA, play music.
It's alright, it's alright, alright.
Hey, SENA, mesh on.
Mesh intercom on. Open mesh. Channel 1.
Hey, SENA, next.
Next.
Hey, SENA, stop music. Hey, SENA, camera on.
Camera on.
Hey, SENA, recording.
Recording.
Hey, SENA, stop recording.
Recording stopped.
Hey, SENA, mesh off.
Mesh intercom off.
Hey, SENA, play music. Siri and Google Assistant. The 50C supports the Siri and Google Assistant access directly. You can activate the Siri or Google Assistant using the voice through the headset's microphone. A wake word will be used. This is a word or groups of words such as Hey Siri or Hey Google. Activate the Siri or Google Assistant installed in your smartphone. Hey Google or Hey Siri, or tap the phone button. Hey Siri, take me to the nearest Shell gas station.
One possibility I see is Shell on Healdsburg Avenue in Healdsburg. It adds 47 minutes to your route. How about that one?
Yes.
Getting directions to Shell.
Your next stop is Shell. In 16 miles, take exit 504 onto West Side Road.
Now, there is a learning curve on the voice commands. Be patient, practice at home, and slow rides around the neighborhood to get the hang of it. I suggest getting familiar with the button first, Then bring in the voice commands as you get comfortable with them. Lastly, do not make up your own SENA commands. If you want to call your wife Betty Boop, you have to say what it says in your phone's contact list, Betty Boop. You cannot say, "Hey Siri, call my honey." So in the last segment, we showed you how to make a phone call. So to answer a call, you tap the phone button or tap the jog dial. To end a call, tap the phone button or hold the jog button down for 2 seconds. To reject a call, hold the jog button down for 2 seconds. If you have a GPS device connected, you will not hear its voice navigations during a phone call. So this is a no-brainer for me. It's voice commands all the way. And earlier in this video, we showed you how they work. Practice makes perfect. But if you want to use the buttons, hold the jog dial for 1 second and release, and that will start and stop music. To track forward or backwards, press the jog dial and rotate it right or left to go forward or backward. So as we learned in the last segment, up to 3 other writers can be paired with the 50C headset for Bluetooth intercom conversations. Here is the diagram. You and B hold the jog dial down for 5 seconds until you hear intercom pairing. The user's headsets will be automatically paired. Repeat the steps above to pair with other headsets C and D. For more information, read the manual for all the setting modes. But for my money, it's voice commands again. And here's the video. Hey, SENA, pairing intercom.
Intercom pairing.
Hello, 1, 2, 3. Intercom's working. Now you have all this video on your SD card, what do you do with it? RKA has been using MOV AVI software. .MOV and .AVI are video file formats, hence comes their name. It is inexpensive and easy to use with very low learning curve. This image is of this video in production. It is complicated with many tricks and features at play. This is the beginning empty screen. There are 3 main sections you will be working on and with. Bottom area is the storyboard where you build your video. Then you have the working screen where you can see what you are building. Next, the file bin. This is where you add files, keep your loaded media files, create sounds, music, backgrounds, effects, titles, captions, and more. For a beginner, just load 1 file and save it as an MP4 file, and you have produced your first movie. You can start out with just putting in your first clip and making it into a media MP4 file. Here is a screen that you would see when starting a project. Drag, load the media file into the bin, top left. Drag that file to the storyboard, bottom. Now you can see the clip on the screen, right. This screen shows the file pull-down that shows the save movie as a media file option. Follow the directions and you have your first movie clip. From here on out, it's up to you to learn how to make titles, endings, captions, and add music by reading the manual or stay tuned to the RKA video on this subject coming sooner than you may think. Have fun playing with your new SENA 50C. Ride safe and have fun.